Hi everyone, I'm Ibrahim Ulkaya from YouTube Developer Relations team, and today we'll talk about YouTube subscribe button. And joining me, Kurt Williams from YouTube Product Experience, joining me today from the Paris office. Hi Kurt, how are you?
Hi, thanks for having me, I'm doing good.
Great. So as you guys maybe already figured out, we recently launched the YouTube subscribe button, and Kurt is the product manager, and he will actually tell us a little bit about more in detail. So maybe let's get started. So what is YouTube subscribe button and what is the motivation behind this button?
Yeah, so the subscribe button is something we've had on the desktop site for a long time. Clicking the button on the desktop site allows you to connect with the creator behind the video. But what we launched recently is the ability for creators to embed the same subscribe button that you find on YouTube.com actually on their own site, so on a third-party web app. So the motivation is pretty simple. There's a lot of creators who have a presence off of YouTube, and we wanted to give those folks a way for their fans, for their followers, to subscribe to their channel directly on their property.
That sounds good. So, but how is it different than the subscribe button on the YouTube channel, on the YouTube website already?
So previously there was never a way directly to subscribe to a channel on a third-party site. So what we've tried to do is emulate the button in every way we can. So it's very similar to how it is on YouTube.com itself. We give a couple additional options to developers for the third-party button where they can change the style and the color to make it integrate well into their property. But otherwise it behaves just like the button behaves on YouTube.com.
Oh, that sounds great actually. And what are some advantages of implementing this button, actually?
So the main thing behind this button, or the main reason why you'd want to put this on your site, is you can, like I mentioned before, you can give the folks who come to your web property an easy way to subscribe to your channel without actually leaving your site. So prior to the launch of this button, there was no way for your fans, your followers, to subscribe to your channel on your own site. You would have to go to YouTube, you'd have to sign in, you'd have to find the button to subscribe there. This is sort of a way for your fans and your followers to connect with you directly on your property without leaving.
Oh, that's great. So how can actually the developers start using this button? How can they generate the code for this button?
So we've launched documentation, which is live. And when you go to the documentation site, we have a nice editor where you can go, you can click around, you can see how the button would render on your page. And we give you sort of right there some HTML code that you can put on your site to render the button. If you're more advanced, if you want more advanced features, we also dive into the details about how you can customize this on your own, how you can tweak the HTML and JavaScript in various ways to solve your use case.
Maybe actually we can show this in a demo right now. So if you guys go to the developers.google.com YouTube, and you'll just click the YouTube subscribe button here on the left navigation, and you will be able to see all the content, all the configuration options here. So your standard channel, or either be like a paid channel, you'll see the default button, or you will have different options having like a full layout or with the dark theme. And all you need to is actually go to use the configure button option here, and you'll put your channel name or your channel ID. And as you see, there's already a preview on the right side, and you can change the preview as having the whole full preview with the channel's image and the channel's name, and you can even go for like a darker layout. And all you need to is actually, if you are like a beginner and you want to do like an easy way, all you need to is copy this code and paste it in your own HTML, and from there you will have the subscribe button. But if you want to go further ahead, you want to use the dynamic rendering, and then we'll actually have the dynamic rendering code here in our documentation as well. So that should be like pretty easy for that. And besides this one, actually, how can you, once you say that, you said actually that you can render this dynamically, and what are the advantages of the dynamically rendering dynamically?
Yeah, so we've enabled for advanced folks who want to render the button dynamically. It improves the speed of their page's rendering time, as well as do different things. If you want to do some custom integrations on your site, or you want to do some advanced features, we enable that too. But yeah, like you mentioned, for the simple user who just wants to come and embed the button, we have a nice editor to let you do that. But the documentation discusses about rendering the button dynamically and doing various different things. So we sort of have the whole spectrum from beginner to advanced user. We support both cases.
Okay. As you mentioned, the subscribe button is like a great tool for people to subscribe to your channel without leaving your own website on your web property. But which mediums actually the user will see once they actually go to your website, or could they be using any other mediums?
Yeah, so once a user actually clicks subscribe, the one big advantage of that is your channel will show up across all of YouTube's platforms. So not just on the desktop side, but on our mobile applications, on TV, on third parties, etc. So an advantage to putting the subscribe button on your site is when your fans come and they click it, now your channel will sort of be unlocked on all the platforms YouTube is on, not just on desktop, but across our mobile apps, TV, etc.
That's great, actually. I hope like all our actual users like start using that, and that will add them to all their channels, and there'll be like way more subscribers just using that, I believe.
And yeah, it's a great way to improve your channel, gain more subscribers, etc.
Okay, thanks for joining me today, Kurt, and that was great, and I'm sure like users will just start using it already.
Thank you.
And for the last thing, I want to plug all the time, and as developer relations engineer, as developer developer relations, we are hiring. You should just go. You can just go to developer.google.com/jobs, and we are hiring almost everywhere in the world, and you can select like which product area is best for you. But I hope you guys go and check it out. Thanks for joining me today, guys. Ibrahim Mulukaya from New York.